Call the Bluff, Aces High, Jokers Wild, Book 2. Written by O.E. Tearmann. Narrated by Kirt Graves. Reader advisement. This book contains romantic and sexual scenes between people whose genders may not fit your expectations. If this offends you, consider yourself warned. Everyone else, buckle up for the ride. Event File 1. File Tag. Base of Operations. Timestamp: 1000 hours. October 30th, 2155.
Whoomp!
The explosion sent a geyser of dust into the sky. Base Commander Aiden Headley cursed as pebbles rained down on him. He crawled out of the empty cistern pit he'd leaped into and stood, trying to wave the dust away without much success. The grit settled on him like a second skin. Adrenaline was treating his guts like its personal skate park and taking some extra turns around his heart. But that wasn't his biggest problem right now. Hell, it didn't make top 10 on his list. He scrambled up the hill and raised his voice.
What the hell was that? We weren't supposed to be blowing anything up today.
Two dark faces peered out from under helmets in their own culvert, trepidation in their eyes. Aiden sighed. Dilly and Donnie. Again. The twins had turned 13 a week ago. Maybe he should be happy that they had started begging to do vocational apprenticeship the minute they'd gotten out of bed on their birthday. But if they kept up this kind of crap, they wouldn't live to 14.
Sorry, Aiden, the girl called. We're trying out a new setting mechanism.
The boy beside her hollered over,
I think I know what I did wrong.
You better know what you did wrong, Aiden growled as he scrambled down the other side of the new site's hill toward his charges, chest still tight with the dregs of his fear.
We can't afford a blast like that again, you hear me? You guys know how dangerous drawing attention is.
Dilly flinched. Her twin's shoulders stiffened.
Okay, but we hit water, Donnie countered. There's water down there and...
The fuck did you two little gamagets do?
Both twins flinched as Janice Danvers climbed out of the nearest water tank, still on its side and empty so soon after the base's site change. Fire in her black eyes, the hydroelectric specialist stalked across the dusty red earth and grabbed the collars of both teenagers' ponchos like the scruffs on a pair of puppies, shaking them in what looked like ferocity. Since the kids were barely shifting for all the show Janice put on, Aiden pushed down his instinct to step between an angry adult getting physical and a pair of kids. In the 7 months since Aiden had taken his place commanding the Wildcards unit of the Democratic State Force, he'd learned to let Janice have her say with anyone pulling idiot stunts. She was a more effective scolder than him any day.
The ever-loving frag grenade fucking hell does wait till I get it damped down mean to you two little sons of sister fuckers, huh? Or how about let me check your work before we go to the next bit?
Janice demanded.
I said wait. You could have killed yourselves, you clusterfucked CPS dumbasses. What are you, a pair of gammas? This is the middle of a relocation setup. You think I got time for you two playing around? You want to help me out, you listen to me, you hear?
She knocked their heads together, and Aiden noted the control the muscled woman used in doing it. Just hard enough to sting, nowhere near hard enough to do the damage Janice could have dished out.
Aw, Jan,
Dilly began, but Janice cut her off.
Don't start. You two ain't...
She glanced up, caught sight of another dark figure in the blazing sun, and raised her voice.
Damien? Come over here and deal with your family.
Turning, the scarecrow of a man got a look at the two dust-covered teenagers. He sighed, putting a hand over his cybernetic eyes.
Dilly, Donnie, what did you do now?
Nothing,
Dilly defended. Striding over, Damien set a hand on each teenager's shoulder, raising a brow. His ocular implants whirred, punctuating the expression.
Nothing, huh?
He glanced with pointed attention from the crater to the boxes of explosive material much too close.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.